Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
According to legend, Atlantis was an island that disappeared beneath the ocean after a massive earthquake. The first written accounts of this event were in two works of the ancient Greek philosopher Plato, 428-347 BC, Timaeus and Critias, in which Plato mentions Atlantis as an example of a utopian society. Citing his source as Solon, a Greek statesman who, well over a century earlier, had received his information about Atlantis from Egyptian priests, Plato says that 9,000 years earlier Atlantis had been an island empire located in the Atlantic Ocean near Gibraltar. Its people were aggressive expansionists who conquered many lands, until they attacked Athens. At this point, the gods decided to defend Athens by destroying Atlantis, whereupon the island experienced massive earthquakes and floods that wiped out its entire civilization. The island then sank beneath the sea, leaving no trace of its existence. Plato's reliability. Skeptics believe that Plato's tale of Atlantis was nothing more than an allegory created to make a point that no matter how advanced, a civilization that ignored its gods in favor of material comfort was doomed. But those who believe that Atlantis really existed argue that Plato provided far more details about the place than would have been necessary in order to make a moral point. In fact, Critias offers elaborate descriptions of Atlantis's architecture, engineering, and ceremonies that would be completely unnecessary if Atlantis were only a literary device. Moreover, Plato himself stated that the story of Atlantis was true, and historians know that the source he had cited, Solon, was a real Greek statesman who had visited Egypt and would have had the opportunity to hear the stories, just as Plato claimed. Believers in Atlantis disagree, however, on whether Plato was correct in saying that the civilization was located on an island in the Atlantic Ocean near Gibraltar. Those who believe that Atlantis was located there base their view on arguments put forth in Atlantis, The Antediluvian World, published in 1881. Its author, Ignatius Loyola Donnelly, accepted Plato's description of Atlantis as real and accurate. Moreover, Donnelly concluded that all the world's ancient civilizations stemmed from one even older civilization, which in his mind could only have been Atlantis. He theorized that the Atlanteans were the first civilized humans, that the royal family of this island eventually spread out over the world to create other, similar civilizations in Egypt, India, and elsewhere, and that based on the places where the first of these civilizations developed, Plato's theory of the location of Atlantis made sense.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.